Good morning, students. In the last session, we have discussed about transgenic animals. In this class, I am going to teach three different topics. One is ethical issues, second biopiracy, third patent. Okay, three small topics. So what is meant by this ethical issues? Manipulation of living organisms by the human race requires certain regulations. Ethical standards are required to evaluate the morality of human activities that might help or harm living organisms. Okay, so always we need some ethical standard to evaluate the morality of human activities that might help or harm living organisms. Clear? Genetic modification of organisms, GMO, you learned in the previous classes. GMO, genetic modification of organisms have unpredictable results when such organisms are introduced into the ecosystem. So we are making new varieties of organisms. So they are called GMO, or genetic modified organisms. When we introduce into the ecosystem, sometimes it may be good, sometimes it may be bad or harmful or harmless. Okay. So they have unpredictable results when such organisms are introduced into ecosystem. So what government decided? Indian government has set up organizations such as GAC, Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. What is the full name? GAC? GAC means Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, which will make decisions regarding the validity of GM research and the safety of introducing GM organisms for public services. So this organization, they will decide what is the validity of genetically modified research and the safety of introducing such organisms for public services. Clear? The modification or usage of living organisms for public services like food, genetically modified food or medicine or anything, has also created problems with patents. Okay? I'll tell you, after this I'll explain what is meant by patent. So such new variety or genetically modified organisms, modifications or usage of living organisms for public service like food or medicine, anything, it also created problems with patents. Okay, what is meant by patent? Patent means, patent is a grant of protection for an invention. It's granted by the US Patent and Trademark Office and has a term of 14 to 20 years. Owning a patent gives you the right to stop someone else making, using or selling your invention without your permission. So that is called patent. Then, use of genetic materials, plants and biological resources by companies granted with patent has triggered public anger since they have been identified, developed and used by farmers and people of specific countries. What happened here? So they started uses this genetic materials and plants and biological resources by the companies, multinational companies. So obviously what will happen, it triggered public anger because actually these type of, especially the farmers of different countries, they identify, develop and use all these varieties of crops or whatever it may be. But what happened, these companies, they made some changes. They made genetically modified organisms or plants and started to sell. Okay, so this triggered public anger since they have been identified, developed and used by farmer and people of specific country. For that, one example is given here. Over 2 lakhs varieties of rice found in India, which makes India richest. So in our country, we have different varieties of rice. They're telling nearly 2 lakhs varieties of rice. Basmati rice, one type of rice with unique aroma and flavor. And there are 27 documented varieties of basmati grown in India. So if you are taking our country, the basmati rice is one of the very good, it gives very good aroma and flavor. In our country, we have 27 different varieties of basmati rice. In 1997, an American company got patent rights on basmati rice through US Patent and Trademark Office. So what happened? In 1997, an American company got patent rights on basmati rice through US Patent and Trademark Office. So what is meant by patent? Patent is a grant of protection for an invention. It's granted by the US Patent and Trademark Office and has a term of 14 to 20 years. Owning a patent gives you the right to stop someone else from making, using or selling your invention without your permission. Clear? This will allow the company to sell a new variety of basmati in the US and abroad. So once they will get the patent, what will happen? This will allow company to sell a new variety of basmati in US and also abroad. This new variety of basmati had actually been derived by crossing with semi-dwarf varieties and claimed as an invention or a novelty. So how they made this new variety? Just crossed with semi-dwarf varieties and claimed as an invention or a novelty. The patent extends to functional equivalence, implying that other people selling basmati rice could be restricted by the patent, like our countries. Okay, in our countries, our farmers, they are making varieties of basmati rice, 27 varieties. But because of this patent, what happened? Other people selling basmati rice could be restricted by the patent. Clear? So you can see here some pictures. Say no to GMO, genetically modified organisms. Yes, same like this new inventions, it was started affecting our country, especially some medicinal plant like turmeric, neem, etc. So several attempts have also been made to patent users, products and processes based on Indian traditional herbal medicines, especially turmeric or neem. What happened? It also started affecting our Indian traditional medicines, herbal medicines like turmeric and neem, etc. We should be vigilant and counter these patent applications, else other countries or individuals may encash on our rich legacy and we may not be able to do anything about it. So this traditionally we have all this rich in for the production of the turmeric and neem, etc. So such companies, multinational companies, they started to produce new varieties or new genetically modified organisms. So what happened? We should be very vigilant and counter these patent applications, else other countries or individuals may encash on our rich legacy and we may not be able to do anything about it. Then what is meant by biopiracy? The patenting of plants, genes and other biological products that are indigenous to another country. Actually, I told it's producing from traditionally we are cultivating this rice, especially now we told, excuse me, there are 2 lakh varieties of rice crops are producing in our country. So it is mainly for the farmers, they're getting money through this, they are living with this rice cultivation. So the patenting of these plants, genes and other biological products that are indigenous to another country. Biopiracy, use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned without compensatory payment. So how these multinational companies are doing that without proper authorization from other countries and also from the people, those who are living in other countries, no concern without compensatory payment. Clear? So developed countries like US, developed countries patent the knowledge and resources of underdeveloped countries and enjoy immense profit. So they started to get immense profit. So actually it is the traditional knowledge or resource of the developed countries, developing and underdeveloped countries. Who started to use this? Developed countries. Developed countries patent the knowledge and resources of underdeveloped countries and enjoy they are getting immense profits or money. Industrialized nations are rich financially, but poor in biodiversity and traditional knowledge. Okay, so we have like our country, like India, we have very good biodiversity and traditional knowledge, but these industrialized nations, they are rich in financially or they are rich, but poor in biodiversity and traditional knowledge. In contrast, the developing and underdeveloped world is rich in biodiversity and traditional knowledge related to bioresources. Traditional knowledge related to bioresources can be exploited to develop modern applications and can also be used to save time, effort, and expenditure during their commercialization. Clear? You can see here one picture. Stop the patenting mafia, Greenpeace. Yes. Realization of the injustice. So they are doing injustice for other countries. So realization of the injustice, inadequate compensation, and benefit sharing between developed and developing countries led some nations to develop laws like India, like our countries. What we develop some laws to prevent such unauthorized exploitation of bioresources and traditional knowledge. So we cannot sit simply because they started to earn money. Our farmers not getting, they are losing their jobs. So what we should do? We should be made some, the nation, they develop some laws to prevent such unauthorized exploitation of bioresources and traditional knowledge. So in our country, what we made, the Indian Parliament has cleared the second amendment of the Indian Patent Bill that takes such issues into consideration, including patent terms, emergency provisions, and research and development initiative. Okay, so our parliament cleared the second amendment of the Indian Patent Bill that takes such issues into consideration. So that is about ethical issues, biopiracy, and patent. Thank you, children.